Hello everyone, this is Serious Trivia. Welcome back to another episode of our legendary Raze the World Loophole Let's Play. We continue for episode 27 from turn 131 in the harvest season of 220. So, last time we raised the second Emperor seat, first one being our own, of course. And while we were tearing it up in the south, Shuch was growing like a tumor here in the central plains, and we have to put him down. So, let's do this first. We're gonna advance towards his position. I don't think we need to put ourselves in march, because it's not like his army is that weak, and it's not like our army is that strong. We rely heavily on two sets of poison volley to really do damage, and we have to respect what he can do to us. Meanwhile, we have to turn back and tear up this army here. Let's see. Not unbreakable. Probably... we got one. So because commanders, obviously, open field, couple cataphracts. Wow. Those are gonna hurt. Let's do a night battle and try to kill 3,000 people here. We would have much preferred them to be out in the open field to give us a full movement reset. Now we really can't go very far. We're gonna go look for Yan Baihu's army, who has colonized again. Hopefully he's in it. If not, you know, getting stock from killing him, not the most important thing for us. So we're probably gonna wipe his faction out. We have much more important things to do, like hunting down Cao Cao's territories. That's a lot of troops. Okay, we're gonna go do what we can. Now, we know there's gotta be an oil puddle somewhere here. Haven't found it yet. Well, actually, they don't have a tower or wooden stakes. Maybe they didn't play their deployables here. And they're also... Well, that's wooden stakes, so it might be here. I usually put it on the left side. I can't see it. Might be in the forest as well. And it doesn't matter how dense they get. I can't roar because there's a general with unbreakable. So we're going to try to hold that roar for as long as we can. And we'll just pick off easy targets for now. Can't find it. Like, see the wooden stakes right here? So I would assume the oil will be somewhere here. But it's not. I get a slam. Got the slam. Let's get out. Actually, no one injured us there. I mean, it's not on this side either. Yeah, I haven't found it. We can kill that boy right there. Alright, we're gonna go after this. Oh, they're killing their own cavalry. Much appreciated. Get a slam off. There we go. We're still uninjured. Alright, we got charged by that cavalry. Chunked us a little bit. Let's see if we can get some kills here. Ooh, he's coming after us. I actually kind of want to turn around and try to kill him. Ah, cavalry bumped us. Alright, not worth. We can go pick up a heal. No rush, still early. Too many spear around him. You wanna come fight? I mean, if he dies, we bring the army out to opening and we try to roar on them. Spears clumping up. There we go. Trying to not fight those cataphracts. Kind of hard for us to kill them as well. Loop around this building. Still relatively healthy. Alright, we really just want him. Reset. He's almost dead. Not the cataphracts. Ooh. That hurts. All right, how do we get to him? I think we have opening. Just need to land one hit, really, before these spears get to us. Can't make it work. Lot of spears left. Come on, don't hide in there. Alright, we'll tackle the hard stuff. Maybe? Yes, we did it. Okay, now we can look for a wrap of all of them. Alright, that was good. I think we can even throw in one more heal. They'll all get wiped. Don't need to chase anyone. We're pretty much full. Yeah, it's like 23 and change. Alright, now we're just hoping Sun Quan and Sun Ren summon themselves, and also Zheng Jiang's in the faction, because we married her over here, our adopted daughter. Alright, how do we do this in terms of where we're walking? I think we're walking towards Yan Bai Hu's claim, because at least that means it's definitely an army there. We should probably be able to reach it. There's no army from Sun Quan right now, we have vision over all three of his remaining territories, so we'll get a good look at what he does with it. This army's there. We're trying to pull this army back. I realize that, you know, Gaoshun needs some screen time, and since he's not in with this army, what we could do is summon him here and then march down here just to wipe out Kong Yi's faction here. It's not super important. I don't know how often Yellow Turban Rebels would colonize. Could be the case where Cao Cao's coming to get that. But I would feel comfortable with Gaoshun on the field here with maybe our daughter. We also have another daughter with the Buren trait. So maybe these three can travel along together. Now, I am a little concerned about our income, so not gonna start recruiting right away. We're gonna see what Cao Cao does, and if there's an opening, we might give them an army to do some stuff, or else we just can't afford it. Oh, he went back and forth, so Cao Cao did take it. I need money. Take my land. Come take my land. He's deep in the heart of, I guess, Cao Zhang's land right now. This Yellow Turban Rebel is going north. I mean, they're going probably to where their land is, which is right there. They're not at war with us, so we don't do anything to them. I could just go raise that, but this is a more interesting target. Alright, they summoned the army here. I'm more curious about an army here potentially. Oh, along the way. Perfect. Oh, please tell me we have enough movement. Oh, come on. Lady Wu got married into Yemehu's faction? Is that why Sun Quan's in power? That's what happened. Right, these will just recall. This is sort of their way to heal. I don't know why they went here and then went back. Sieging them in a level 0 city is actually really good. Because we get the big morale debuff. Now, we don't have night battle, so we're not going to get the huge morale debuff. And they actually assigned an administrator here to give them some more units. Wow. Commitment. He has resiliency, so as long as we don't execute him, he'll still be around for people to take down later. So I think we're just going to fight this. This is the battle of 8 poison volleys. If we land them right in those narrow city streets, really should just be no contest. They do have siege weapons. What we're gonna do is we're gonna back everyone up. We're also gonna try to hide everyone as well. And these two are going to be leading the charge in the beginning. I believe one of them actually has stock. Yep. So we'll use her first. Qingzhou units got bored and start burning themselves. Not like you need any more city destruction. Yeah, you can imagine poison volley down this aisle. The town folks exposed us, that's fine. We're just gonna fire at that one right there in the middle. Let's do it. Don't disrupt us, don't disrupt us, don't disrupt us, don't disrupt us. Oh, come on. Did they actually break the animation, or am I still gonna queue for it? Oh, it broke because I still have 4. Maybe I got too ambitious. The town folks need to get away so I can get invisible again. Eight seconds. I guess I'll just shoot. Let's try it again. We can do it. There we go. Perfect. Doesn't matter if you give a little range block chance. It's good use, but we're just here for the poison damage. Smoke screen? Caltraps? Yeah, we're moving so slowly, it must be caltraps. And we also have poison arrows afterwards. Why is this animation? Oh, he probably lost vision of that unit. I think most of the units there are actually all dead. We'll let the smoke screen clear and then we'll figure out what's going on here. Yeah, cavalries are not going to be affected as much because they only have 30 entities. Well, they're trying to shoot us. I want to see what's going on over there. He used up all his ammo. We took quite a chunk. Like, are there still infantry here or no? That's going to affect whether we shoot here or not. How long do smokescreen last? Feels bugged. It shouldn't be this long. Oh, there we go. Ah, it's all cavalry for the most part. I mean, there's a couple in the back. I think we can aim for that. And we want that full poison to tick for the 30 seconds before we do anything else with the second shot, or else we're just wasting it. How to kill the generals will be a difficult question, actually. We're gonna ignore this cluster for a little bit. We could use the cavalry to kill generals. That's probably our best bet. Gonna have to kill this thing first. Might be dangerous the second we step on this, and they just charge us. So let's not step on it, and then try to shoot this angle, see if we can get some shots. That does not look good. I guess this is not a victory point, they don't really even care. Well, why can't I just shoot that? Can I shoot this? Okay, there we go, we stopped moving. Okay, I got some spread on the back, so that's a win. Gonna loop back to the front, kill that spear unit. And then we're gonna move our units in. How are they responding there? Are they actually defending or they're charging out? Alright, looks like they're just spreading out defend. They have no range left, so technically we can harass the infantry with this in the same manner as Poison Volley. One shot there, one shot there. Oh, we're kind of trapping ourselves. Not cool. Run out. Oh, we had a oil puddle there. Might be a waste of ammo. Might as well use this. Look at that cavalry, three single file line. I mean, the idea here is we should be able to wipe out all their infantry before we have to make a move on their cavalry. Well, I'm favored? I mean, I have a good weapon and all, but I don't know if I'm favored. I'm gonna believe in the game. Let's see if we can get that. We want to hamstring pretty early. Alright, Xu Shu got knocked off. We got first hit. Because we want to stop his ability cooldown. So that he can never use it, basically. I don't know if I'll win, but we're not going to sit here and wait. We might get some friendly fire. We might scratch. Nope, no friendly fire. We're good. Oh, okay. We got ourselves poisoned, but not usual poison. That's really bad because we lose attack rate. I was hoping to help. I'm so sorry. Alright, looks like their cavalry and their infantry are gone. Gonna try to use ability. This one's gonna be close. Clear out cavalry charge. Oh, who killed who? Oh, I choked him out. I won. Woo!
Alright,
Get back on your horse. Ooh, we're stepping our own cow traps. Not what we want. Army loss? I think we got them. Whew. That worked like a charm. Now it's just going to be a lot of free claims, because even though they recolonize, I don't think they'll level it up, so there's plenty no garrison everywhere. We just need to walk by every location and make sure we raise them again. You we can execute. Chuchu we're gonna let go to give Li Bo a shot. Alright, we'll just raise these pretty quickly. This one's level 1 has no garrison, so right, these are just free takes. I could not touch that army, unfortunately. Not sold on what we should do, so not gonna touch that one. I think we're good. Let us continue here.
We can wait until the last moment.
Finally paying us. Yeah, that's the thing about recolonization. Like, we're not super scared of that situation. Because as long as we beat the army doing it, all the land that they retaken are just like free reclaims for us as well. Or in this case, they have a small retinue. And this case they don't. Yeah, we'll fix this relatively quickly. They're in the middle of nowhere. That's perfect. Because we can use them to bounce into their settlement. They're actually going to be dragging the garrison out. I don't really actually care. Is she unbreakable? Level 6. She's not. Okay. Lady Wool. So we're going to roar on her, let her retreat, hopefully past the settlement. We take the settlement with night battle, so we don't attack her. And then we attack her, wipe out the faction. And then we're going to move on to Sun Quan's land. You're actually standing here to protect your son and daughter. And that's all we're really gonna do. Yeah, I think we can make it work. Like I said, we just night battle this to prevent that army from not taking part. Lady was also level 6. Like, her high level helped her resist getting captured after that battle. guys are coming out. Can I roar? I don't think it's everyone, but like we're just gonna roar on this. Oh, it is everyone. Let the heal tick and then we're done. I thought they would have like one or two units over there. Even though we still have plenty of movement, we're still gonna wipe out the faction. This can just be a delegate at this point. I don't need to capture Lady Wu. Alright, Yan Bai Hu's wiped. Man, these terrain distances are just crazy. I'm gonna ignore Wang Lang for now. I feel like his army's out here. So instead, we're just gonna focus on Sun Quan here. He has not summoned himself, or his sister, or his wife, all three of which are our targets. Xu Chu has been resummoned back here, which is actually kind of perfect. So we're gonna fight our way back. They're gonna raise all these again. And then maybe they can hop over and help. Yeah, we're gonna let the yellow turbans walk through. They're going on an interesting journey as well. Oh, they don't quit. Zhuge Liang has joined Sun Quan's faction. Oh, Sun Ren is with Wang Lang. Okay. Good to know, good to know. Alright, we got everyone. Wait, no way. We got everyone. How did that happen? Did I miss something? Someone in the forest that we just didn't see? It's becoming a little bit more of a chore.
快集合兵力! 将军有难!
Come on, you guys know you guys can't beat us. Just leave.
Shengli jin zai zhichi!
Alright, finally. I think we just need the 1k little buffer heal. It's good enough. We don't have instant siege. I guess we never got it last time either. Wrong army. Hold on, let me break the siege first. See if we can get it on him. No, not the right. Okay, can we move them out of enemy territory? Just to raise. Now can we get Lu Bu? There we go. Wait, our spy came back to us? I guess after the faction wipe, we just haven't been paying attention. Don't really care about that Han faction character kill Xiao Qiao. That's a bit cruel. Yeah, we only need that one. Not that useful for us. Honestly, what is useful for us? Champion happiness? Maybe. Building upkeep discount. We need a building for that. State workshop, I think. Alright, champion satisfaction it is. Yeah, we don't necessarily have the money to field another army. We'll move them closer to Hefei. We'll bump both these at the same time, and then they can play crossover and take care of that. Ah, we broke siege, so we can't. That's a bummer. Maybe Zhugudan will come and give us a fight. Suren, obviously, we would love to hit. No garrison, easy garrison, no garrison, Cao Cao's land, going pretty deep, so we're gonna have to like... I mean, we technically don't need to wipe him, we can just go for his capital. I am actually tempted to recall Lu Bu after we get Sun Ren's mark, and then resummon him here, and then basically go fight Xu Chu, go fight Cao Cao. That might be the way to do it, actually. Alright, so that's really all we can do, unfortunately. We have another son. Always curious about the character name. Oh, what a complicated character. Okay. Weird character. Maybe they're trying to avoid, like, getting overlap names with a historical character, and that's why they, like, choose such weird characters, maybe. Nama is tearing things up. They're just not fighting us for some reason. We're at war with them. I don't know why they're not going to Shangyong. We're gonna come out? Nope, they're not coming out. Another granddaughter. Is that a... That's a grandson. Liu Zhang's kid. Zhou He... What? Like, how... Even two character names are weird. Now we have a three character name. They do have an extra garrison. This one's gonna be a little bit difficult, but we got this. Alrighty, so going for the town center is definitely the play. I guess this would be the area to do it. We will want to keep our forces over far away because of the siege weapon. Or at least the unit needs to be hidden. The generals can show. I don't know if I need my horse, actually, here. I could just ignore everything and head for the square, which I think is the play, actually. Yeah, they can keep shooting at us, not a problem. That's actually considered missile damage, so the range block chance would actually block it. Alright, freeze. Oh, didn't pull it off in time, but... We still have more capture weight than that one unit. Not anymore, but... I mean, they're sending archers at us. Just give us the capture point first, and then we'll talk. I think it's fine to use the roar. We're just chasing people off the point. We haven't captured it yet, but I think now we should easily. Is it now ours? I mean, there's only archers left. All right, we got it. Honestly, if we just kill this, no one can actually get close enough. Alright, 30 seconds, it's over. And the army lost before, so... I think we can leave the copper mine for the army coming down from the north. And we want to start shifting west.
Gong wu bu ke, zhan wu bu sheng. Sha!
Right, so we can like ignore that, because we can let them cross over and do it. Oh, they put administrator here to die? Yeah, it wasn't hard to undo Xu Chu's work. Now we're gonna use the crossing. Yeah, they'll be able to hit this next turn. We can focus our attention west. Looks like we can actually take out Zhuge Liang this turn. Question is, do we want to take this fight here? I don't think he has Stifling Deluge. I don't know if she's unbreakable or not. It wouldn't really matter. The map is really bad because it is a iron mine. So maybe we opt for easy target first and see if we can draw them out. Ideally, we fight them on the field. What's up with all these? Oh, Guo Huai. Sure, we will just fight this. Just a roar. We also get a heal. Just trying to run out of the tower range. So many towers, let's get back out. The heal hasn't finished taking it. I think we actually lost health in this fight. Ah, shame. Right, so I think we put ourselves in a position where Sun Quan will likely hit us. And Zhuge Liang might consider coming out and hit us as well. So that we can pick up the kills easier and then take an easier fight here. Sun Quan gets wiped there. And then we can focus just on the final Emperor seat at that point. Xu Chu, I don't think summoning another full army for them is the solution. Oh, Giant's back. That's okay. It's not really something we're super concerned about. Yeah, it's just something we're not going to be super concerned about. Yeah, let's continue, unless there is... Nope. Not many spies left. 43, Wenhuo at 0.8. Doesn't do us any good. Oh? They might fancy a fight. That would be their doom, because that settlement is not walled. Are they giving us stuff now? Gonna come fight us. Look it out. Let's do it. Let's do it. Oh, you guys have the Celestial Sword. Not unbreakable. Does not have Siphoning Deluge. Not unbreakable. Not unbreakable. Perfect. This is a much easier fight than anticipated. Try to round them all together. That was a good slam. I don't know what these units are doing. If they're not gathering together, we're gonna have to kill them. Or else we can't do our roar. Alright. We got charged by cavalry really, really hard. So, we're gonna need to take a break. Yeah, those cavalry charges, no joke. Do we have a... Oh, we might have it right here. Hold on, if we can loop around... Not around this little town center, which is actually making it more difficult to gather everyone together. If we can grab them all to this side... I would like to get a few more heals as well, so no rush. Already killed you a couple times. Also seems like your new faction, no one really likes you. They're not clumping. Can't really roar here. We can get some picks. Oh, that might be a clump. Yep, we got it. We'll be at 16k health. Still pretty low, but... There's also the fight against Srinren, probably also happening this turn, so we'll get a 3k health at the beginning of that fight, and hopefully we'll do okay. Yeah, it's time to say goodbye to you guys. And hopefully... I mean, I guess we can take money now. We have full supplies. Hopefully Sun Quan comes out to replace these generals. Oh, he did! So we can clear both him and his sister. Valon hasn't taken his turn yet, so we should be able to still get that fight with... Srinren, I hope. Oh no, he took... Oh, there we go. That's the turn we're talking about. Oh, she's got a big old axe. Okay. No problem. Does she have... She does not have her Heartseeker ability. Oh, very roarable. The quality of these units. Night and day. I mean, it makes sense. Sun Quan was emperor for a while. And she no longer has access to their mercenary cavalry, which has that insane near 300 charge bonus that almost took out Ribu last fight. Let's see, we should move these two units to the back. Wait. We have allies? Wait, how are we getting allies? We have friends? I'm gonna run to our friends. We have friends? What garrison is this? It's definitely a garrison. We're not close to any garrisons that I know of. why would Sun Quan's garrison help us, right? I mean, they could be also at war with them, which might be the case. So they're not necessarily helping us, they're just fighting them. But like, wow, that is a first. Go kill yourself because we're attacking them afterwards anyways. Never thought we'll be a EVE observer. Alright, instead of PvP or PvE. This is ready 3x speed. Yeah, we'll let them get destroyed first. Absolutely completely get destroyed. They're picking up our righteous resolve righteous bonus. Yeah, go fight. Oh, at the same time, I'll go kill the Juggernaut, actually. This is beautiful. We'll make sure to approach from behind them so they don't actually get a shot on us. That would be hilariously bad. Bounce back and fight. Be brave, you guys can do it. I just didn't think I was that close to Poyan's iron mine, because I think that's what this unit is. It's the iron mine garrison that we were thinking about, you know, it's going to have a difficult time killing next turn, but now that they have come out to help us, not so difficult anymore. Alright, we did take some damage, so we're going to heal up. Looks like our ally has done their part. Yeah, this is a strange turn of events. I don't even think we need a fancy roar. Oh. Wait, we don't need to kill her like this. I think I got everyone. Yep. I don't think we're gonna get another heal. We probably could wait for one. We'll just do it at the beginning next turn. Yeah, it's definitely Sun Quan's garrison from his last settlement. Poyan's iron mine came out to help us. Sun Quan must be so confused. Like, you guys went out there and fought my sister? Sun Quan's on the middle of the field. That's even better. Use it to bounce off. So we got Sun Quan and Sun Quan. We're going to get Sun Quan as well. 10% campaign movement range. Perfect. So this is a good place to end it. Sun Quan's reign is going to come to an end. You see that Cao Cao is actually sending armies to Shang Yong, which would be their doom. Not because the garrison's scary, but because they just can't beat it. I can loop them. Not only can I loop them, I got the slam combo, so we can finally show off Gao Shun a little bit. Elsewhere, I'm going to ignore that. He can take it. It's fine. We should be able to... Actually, let me do this real quick. This will just be a delegate. Technically this army's done its job. We could think about deleting the units and recalling the generals. Not recalling, but like just walking them back through this emptiness. Save us some money. Think about pumping out some units here. After this is defeated, we're going to be returning here to take on both of the Sun siblings, wiping out Sun Quan as a faction, and then if we do it properly, I think we can use this movement reset to bounce into this army. Oh, Liu Yao. And then get another movement reset to ignore that. I don't think we're going deep south anymore. There's also rebels here, which is good. We're going to just take Changsha here, and then we'll march ourselves over, and then we'll basically get into the heat of the action over here. So that's kind of the plan. Should be very good. I think we have majority of the gold weapons in the game, actually, from all executing all the generals we see. Valon's been very passive, which is good. No funny business with reclaiming the Emperor seat. And we can look forward to wiping out Cao Cao very soon. So, until next time, bye!